So we will see what are the various steps used to solve a transportation problem. The first step is to make a transportation table. So whatever the given problem is, so first you have to make a transportation table, and the second step is to find out the initial basic feasible solution. So to find out the initial basic feasible solution, there are three approaches. The first approach is northwest corner method, and the second approach is least cost method, and the third approach is Ogle's approximation method. And the third step is to find an optimal solution. In this, we have two methods. One is stepping stone method and another one is modified distribution method or UV method. So here I have taken the same example which I have discussed in the previous video. So where we have three supply points and three demand points and various costs are given, that is C11 is 8, C12 is 9, C13 is 7, C21 is 4, C22 is 3, C23 is 5, C31 is 8, C32 is 5, C33 is 6. So here we have to find out the various quantities, okay, that is X11, X12, X13, X21, X22, X23, X31, X32, X33. These are the unknown quantities. We have to find these quantities. So here, in case of northwest corner method, what is the first step means? In this table, we have to pick a top left corner cell. So this is the top left corner cell, and this cell has a supply of 40 units and has a demand of 30 units. Okay, this cell has a supply of 40 units and has a demand of 30 units. So we have to allocate resources to this cell. So how to allocate resources to this cell means take minimum of supply and demand. So the minimum of 40 and 30 is 30. So allocate 30 units to this cell. Once you allocate 30 to this cell, so this quantity, since we have allocated 30, okay, the 30 demand has been met, so this quantity will become zero. Now, so here supply was 40, so we have allocated 30, so 40 minus 30, it is, the remaining is 10. Now here you can see this demand, it has become zero. So there is nothing to allocate to these two cells. So just strike out these two cells. And now the remaining portion of the table consists of only six cells. So in this six cells, again you have to pick up a top left corner cell. So this will be our top left corner cell. So again, now you have to allocate resources to this cell. So how to allocate resources? Pick a minimum of demand and supply. Pick a minimum value that is present in demand and supply. So here the minimum of 10 and 30, it is 10. So allocate 10 here. So once you allocate 10 here, this value will become 0. Again, here in the demand, the remaining will be 20. So since this value has become zero, the available was 40. Since this has become zero, we have allocated 40 resources. So here there is nothing to allocate for this cell. So strike out this cell. Now again, the remaining portion of the cell consists of only these four cells. Again, you have to pick up a top left corner and start allocating the resources. So this is our top left corner. Now we have to allocate resources to this cell. So which is the minimum of 20 and 25? 20. So allocate 20 units to this cell. So once you allocate 20, so this one, okay, this becomes zero. Again, supply was 25, you have allocated 20, the remaining will be 5. And now this has become 0, right? So there is nothing to allocate to this cell, okay? There is nothing remaining, okay, to allocate to this cell. So strike out this cell. Now we have to allocate, now again the remaining portion of the table has only these two cells. So in that, the top left cell is this one. So we have to allocate resource to, maximum resource to this cell. So among this 40 and 5, we have to pick a minimum value. The minimum value is 5, so allocate 5 to this cell. Once you allocate 5 to this cell, this value will become 0, and again this value will become 35. So now we have to, there is only one cell left in the table. Now, so this will be our top left corner. Now we have to allocate resource to this cell. Supply is 35, demand is 35, both are same. So allocate 35 resource to this cell. Now these two values will become 0. Since this is a balanced transportation problem, in the end we will get zeros only. So now you can see the value of x11 is 30, x12 it is 10, x13 it is 0, x21 0, x22 20, x23 it is 5, x31 0, x32 0, x33 it is 35. So out of 9 variables, only 5 variables are contributing to the solution. This will be our feasible solution. These 5 variables will contribute to our feasible solution. So what is the total cost? The total cost will be 8 into 30 plus 9 into 10 plus 5 into 5 plus 6 into 35. So which will be equal to 625. The total cost will be equal to 625.